So yes, during the sandbox event in London, Georgia and me were working on singing voice separation, and we were using the conditioned unit. I guess you all know that singing voice separation is the task where we want to separate the vocals from the rest of the instrumental accompaniment in a song. And nowadays, this is mainly tackled as a supervised learning problem, right? Where we have to provide, we want to train a model and we have to provide a target. So the true answer of what would be the vocals in a mix, but this is something we sketched here. You know, we have a mixture, we give it to a model, it makes some prediction, and we show what would have been the exact right answer, what would have been the source we expect, and then we can update the model, you know, to get a better prediction. But we observed that in the data sets for singing voice separation, this what is defined as singing voice is quite diverse, and it's very difficult to give a really good definition of what should be the singing voice, because we listed here some examples. What are all the possibilities that what can be contained in this target? For example, you can have only one singer, or you can have multiple singers in a song, right? You can then have that if there are multiple singers, you can they can sing only one pitch altogether, or they sing harmonies, so multiple pitches. They can sing all the same words at the same time, or sing different words. So you can have background singers who do some something in the background. And also you can have silent segments, which are challenging because the model is trained right to extract something from the mixture that sounds like the vocals, but on those segments where there are no vocals, you know, the prediction should be silent, which is also challenging for the source separation models. So we were wondering if we define the singing voice target more carefully, taking into account all those possible cases, would this lead actually to better separation quality? And to design our experiment, we started with the conditioned unit, which is a source separation model that was introduced last ISMIR, and it's based on the unit. The unit is just a convolutional neural network with an encoder decoder structure. This was fairly standard for source separation. It takes input a mixture spectrogram, and from this outputs the source you want to separate. But for this network, normally if you want to separate singing voice, you train one network that only separates, that learns how to separate singing voice. If you want to separate bass, you train another unit that is specialized in separating bass. So then the contribution of the conditioned unit was to introduce this conditioning mechanism, where we have an additional input, and this input, which is this here, is just a vector that encodes the idea of the instrument you want to separate, for example the vocals, and it goes into another small network that is the conditioning generator that learns how to modulate the internal representations of this mixture in the network so that the desired source comes out as an output. That means now we can, with this conditioning mechanism, separate all kinds of sources with the same network, depending on what conditioning vector we give here at the input. And we want to do basically the same thing, but instead of separating different instruments with this network, we always want to separate vocals, but we want to differentiate between different cases of vocals. Those ones I have shown here. So we defined four different cases for our experiment. One case is simple, there's only one singer, one singer in the vocals, one singer in the song. Second case is we have multiple singers, but they're singing the same words altogether, sometimes with the same pitch, sometimes different pitches. The third case is we have multiple singers and they're singing different words at the same time and different pitches. And the fourth case is there are no vocals at all. And so we took the MuseDB data set, the mostly used data set for singing voice separation today, and we cut it into segments, which were between 4 and 11 seconds long. And for all of these segments, we labeled with one of these cases for the singing voice. And then we wanted to do, or we did an experiment where we wanted to find out what is the effect of having those labels on the vocal target as opposed to not having them. So we trained this whole model here two times. One time where we gave the actual label C as the conditioning input, right? So we are saying the network, okay, now in this mixture, you should expect one singer. And hopefully this would help the, this would help the network to get a better separation. And as a baseline, we used the exact same model, but we, for all cases, gave always the same conditioning vector. So that means in this way, we can really see what's the inference of this additional information about the vocals, because all other parameters stayed exactly the same. Okay, and we can show you some results of this experiment. Here we are comparing our baseline, which is this non-informed model, if you want, with the voice conditioned unit, which is our informed model. We're comparing the three most used matrix for source separation. And here we show you all the three cases where we have singers, right? These are the bars in the different colors. The case where there are no vocals, we can look at this separately on the next slide. And overall, we can see that the bars for the informed model on the right are almost always higher than on the left for the baseline. So that means in general, as a global picture, we can say that this additional information helped the network for the source separation. And particularly, we can see that for the blue bar, so in the case where there's only one singer present, all the three matrix improve if you compare here the informed model with the baseline. But we can also see, interestingly, that the scores of the matrix are lower for the case with only one singer compared to when we have multiple singers, which maybe at first glance is a bit counterintuitive. And we think that has to do maybe if we have only one singer, there might be less, there's less energy in the vocals and, you know, there might be, so to speak, more difficult to find. And then for the cases with multiple singers, we improved the source to distortion ratio and the source to artifacts ratio, but the source to interference ratio is decreased. That means that in this case, if you have multiple singers, this additional information makes that the separated voice or the separated voices in this case are not degraded or less degraded in any way. But this is, I mean, we pay for this by letting through more other instruments, more interferences. But this is actually, you know, it's a common trade-off in masking-based source separation. Yes, and when we look at the parts with no vocals, it's, you know, those parts are not so easy to evaluate because the standard matrix are not defined when we have, when our target source is all zero. So we cannot use this matrix here, but there's this other matrix that measures the predicted energy at silence. And this is a measure that tells us how much energy the model put into the prediction when the actual targets or our vocals would be silent. So the true answer or the best answer would be no energy at all. But of course, often the separation models maybe confuse another source with the vocals and, you know, put something in the prediction while they shouldn't. So for this measure, lower values are better because you want ideally have no energy at all. Yes, and if you compare the two models again, the informed model puts less energy in those segments where there are no vocals. Yeah, this is somewhat expected because it's, it might be quite easy to learn this transformation. Okay, if I get at the input this conditioning vector telling me always there are no vocals, when you see that during training, it's easy to learn that, you know, when I see this vector, I should output only zeros and this is the best answer. So to sum up, we have seen that defining the vocals target can actually lead to some improvement in single voice separation. And also we have seen that with these additional annotations we did for the database, we can analyze the source separation results a bit more deeper because, you know, we can look into the different cases, what happens if there's only one singer, what happens if there are no singers, and so on. And now in the future, we would like to continue working on the project and we want to test different conditioning mechanisms and also maybe change a bit the number of vocal characteristics we want to look at. Yeah, that was it from our side. Thank you.